Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can count how many numbers are positive, negative and zero in array by passing array into function using pointer. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app Techemis, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I am declaring a function whose name is count. It will receive an argument that will be an address of array. Its return type is void. So this statement is function declaration. After this function declaration, I am defining main function definition. So here I am declaring two variables, an array and variable I. Now with the help of printf, I am going to display the message enter 10 numbers on console. Now this for loop will repeat 10 times to receive 10 elements from user, and all the elements will be received through scanf and they will be stored inside array A. Now I am calling count function and I have passed A array inside it. So this statement is function calling. Here you can see I am passing name of array in form of base address. So whenever we pass name of array into a function call, it automatically pass its base address into the function definition. At last return 0. So this is the definition of main. Now I have to define count function definition. So this block is function definition. Here you can see p pointer is declared, which will receive base address of array A. So with the help of this p pointer, I can access all the locations of array. So first I am declaring some variables here. C1, C2, C3, these are initialized with 0. Now I am implementing for loop, which will repeat 10 times. Inside this for loop, I have to apply conditions for checking positive, negative and 0. So this is first condition. See it carefully. Here asterisk p is written. So p is having base address of array, and asterisk means value at address. So this asterisk will find out the value which is available on that base address, and it will be compared with 0. So if it is greater than 0, then c1 will be incremented by 1. If this condition is false, then asterisk p will be compared with 0. So if this condition is true, C2 will be incremented, otherwise C3 will be incremented. So this way I have checked whether the element which is available at an address is positive, negative or 0. After comparing base location, I have to increase the pointer by 1. So using this p++, pointer will be pointing to the second location of array. And then again asterisk p will be dereferencing that location so that it can find out the value available on that address, and it will be compared with 0, whether it is greater than 0, less than 0 or equals to 0. So accordingly c1, c2 or c3 will be incremented. So this process will repeat 10 times. After completion of loop, the result will be available inside c1, c2, c3. So these results can be displayed on console with the help of printf. So positive count will be displayed, then negative count will be displayed, and then zero count will be displayed, and then c1, c2 and c3, these variables are displayed with help of this printf. So this way I have implemented the complete logic in front of you. Now I am executing this code. It is asking for 10 numbers, so I am entering different numbers. Some are positive, some are negative and some are 0. So you can see the output. Positive are 4, negative are 3 and 0 are 3. So if you look at the input, so here 1, 6, 8 and 5, 4 positive numbers are available. 0 is available 3 times, and negative elements -5, -7, -7, these are available 3 times. So the output is correct. Program is working properly. It is properly counting how many positive, negative and 0 elements are available in array, and I have passed array into function with the help of pointer. So this way I have implemented the logic in front of you. I hope you have understood it well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my programming app TechIMIS, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.